Hello my dear friends, welcome to Knowledge Hub. For few days we have been hearing in the news about emergency use authorization due to COVID-19. Today we will discuss the very topic. The story so far is that the Pune-based Serum Institute of India and Bharat Biotech of Hyderabad, frontrunner among Indian vaccine makers, have been advised by the India's drug regulator, the Drugs Controller General of India, DCGI, to furnish more evidence that their vaccine candidates are safe and capable of preventing COVID-19. Neither company has finished testing its vaccines, but they chose to approach the drug regulator seeking emergency use authorization. So let us learn what is emergency use authorization for drugs and vaccines. In the conventional process of approval, a drug or a vaccine candidate has to pass through many clinical trials. First, it is tested in animals. When it is found safe, it is progressively tested in larger group of people. If it is a vaccine, it is tested in healthy people, and in case of a drug, it is tested in patients. The trials in phase 1, 2, and 3 are designed to establish the drug's safety and efficacy, and promoters of the new drug or vaccine must furnish data from each phase to the country's drug regulators to satisfy them that the results are promising enough to go for the next phase. This process and logistics of execution and evaluation are long, and it often takes years for a new entity to be commercially approved. However, there are several situations when the approval process must be hastened. For instance, a potential drug may be available to treat an extremely debilitating and rare disease, but there are too few patients to devise appropriate clinical trials. Or in another situation, there is an outbreak that is putting several lives at risk, and no proven drugs and vaccines are at hand. Or in another situation, a drug or a vaccine has been properly tested in one country and known to save lives, and will evidently be useful in another country which has neither the resources nor expertise to subject it to similar evaluation. It is under such circumstances that health regulators allow accelerated approval under emergency use authorization. The emergency use authorization is terminology specific to the United States Food and Drugs Administration. It has just given emergency approval to a vaccine developed by Pfizer and BioNTech, the first vaccine to prevent COVID-19 approved in the USA. But several countries have similar provisions under similar names. So now let us look at what is the process in India. India does not have any explicit emergency use authorization provision. However, a section in the rule governing the use and regulation of drugs that came into effect in 2019, called the New Drugs and Clinical Trials Rules 2019, mentions an accelerated approval process depending on the severity of the disease, urgency, rarity, or the lack of alternative treatments. The regulator has the right to waive clinical trials, local clinical trials, if a drug has been approved elsewhere. Also, in the case of a new drug, the medical benefits of the drug are evaluated based on the first two phases of the testing, and the larger, usually more time consuming and expensive phase 3 trial can be deferred. It is under such provisions that the first pharmaceutical companies and then vaccine firms were able to offer drugs such as hydroxychloroquine, remdesivir and favipiravir to COVID-19 patients, even though there was little evidence to show the vaccines worked. Vaccine makers such as Serum Institute of India, Bharat Biotech Limited and Zydus Calida too have been allowed to rely on the efficacy of data from other countries or limited human trials to accelerate their testing process. Now let us look at why did India's drug regulator seek more data. The Drugs Controller General of India has a subject expert committee which regulates technical data from trials. At its meeting on December 9, 2020, the committee said that in the case of Serum Institute of India, it would need updated safety data from the company's ongoing phases, trial phases, two or three trials on 1600 volunteers in India, because Serum Institute of India's vaccine Covishield is a version of Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine candidate whose early results from its phase 3 trials are being scrutinized by the United Kingdom's drug regulators. The Indian committee also wanted to evaluate this data as well as wait for that country's decision on the vaccine. In the case of Bharat Biotech Limited, the regulator wanted to see data from the company's ongoing trial on 28,500 volunteers across India. The committee has not laid bare its reasoning, but the rules say it is free to ask for any data it terms necessary to evaluate the risk-benefit ratio of approving an untested vaccine candidate. So now let us look at the question, what lies ahead? Drugs regulators are not enjoined to approve a drug just because there is a pandemic. However, there is a rare historic moment when drugs and vaccines anywhere, even with the slightest promise, are being given unprecedented leeway and are nudged by the government to rapidly bring an effective vaccine to market. Companies are allowed to furnish interim data they do not have to wait for trials to end before approaching regulators. In the case of Serum Institute of India, the approval of the Chadox-1 vaccine in the United Kingdom could potentially mean almost immediate approval in India. Another factor would be the frequency of adverse events and reactions. While there has been reports of volunteers in global trials and in India too experiencing severe reactions, none has been definitely linked to the administration of the vaccine. Being convinced that Indians, if not significantly benefit, would not come to harm at least, will be a key factor influencing the committee's decision. So that's